Welcome once again to Talking Point. I'm Mayor Mike, and my guest today is our Assistant Chief of Fire, Jeff Davis. Welcome, Jeff.
Thank you, Mike.
I wanted you on here for a couple of reasons. First of all, school's coming back. College students will soon be moving in to dorms and off-campus housing. Youngsters will be riding their bikes to school. So I wanted to give an opportunity for us to let people know what sort of safety tips we want to keep in mind as those students return to school. What are your thoughts?
I think first and foremost, this Pokemon thing has kind of taken off, and we have lots of kids outside the fire station. I just want them to be aware of their surroundings. Don't be looking at the phone all the time. It's great that they all get outside and look at the phone, but just make sure that they're looking around, making sure they're watching traffic. Be careful of that. Yeah. Riding their bikes around, make sure they're wearing their helmets. And as far as the students that are coming in from UWSP, just make sure you have some working smoke detectors, that your CO detectors are working, and you have a fire extinguisher there, and practice your fire safety plans. Make sure that they have two ways out of each one of the buildings that they're in, whether it's residential facility or at the school facility. So.
That's a good point. Students moving into housing and things, you want to make sure that those smoke detectors work.
Yes.
The carbon monoxide detectors work. That's CO that you had mentioned.
CO, yes.
If they find that they move into a place and their smoke detector is broken or non-existent, is there a service that the fire department might offer?
We can actually come over there. Just because it's a private residence, we don't normally do an inspection, but if they do complain about it, yes, we can come over there and take a look at it and just make sure that it's correct and it's in the right spot. And if we need to, we can actually call a landlord and they can come over and make sure that they get it put in. Normally, right in their lease agreement, it'll say in there that they have a one-year lease on it, and that they can't tamper with it or remove the batteries from it. So the kids shouldn't be touching those things, and like I said, it'll save their lives.
Good. We can contact the fire department, contact your landlord, but the fire department would then, in a house, come in and do a complimentary type check just to make sure everything is okay.
Yep.
Better safe than sorry.
Yeah, we just want to make a good peace of mind. I know parents come into town every year, and a lot of times they call us up and just say, hey, could you maybe go over there and check on them? And, we'll do that public safety, call
good.
For them. That's no problem. So,
The other exciting thing coming up now on, what is this, 4 years now that you've been doing this?
3 years.
3 years?
Our Guns and Hoses event.
Guns and Hoses.
Yep.
And Guns and Hoses is the police department versus the fire department.
Correct.
In a charity softball game. Tell me a little bit about that and how it got started.
It got started 3 years ago, and it was a brainchild of Chief Kevin Reuter, and he wanted to do something for the vets here in Portage County, so he decided that maybe we could have a fun softball game and try to raise a little bit of money. Well, a little bit of money has turned into over $100,000 in 3 years. So we've we've given $50,000 to Honor Flight. So we've given 100 Portage County vets rides to Washington, D.C. to see their memorials. And we've given 20-some thousand dollars to the Portage County Veterans Relief Fund. And this year, we're actually got a couple new ones. We're going to donate $5,000 to Dream Flight and then the USSA Hunts, the United Special Sportsmen's Alliance, that myself and Sheriff Lucas are involved in. So.
Okay, and when is Guns and Hoses coming up?
It's going to be August 27th at Buchholz Park. It opens up at 9 o'clock, the gates. Opening ceremonies are going to be at 10:30, and the game starts shortly at 11:05. And right after, like I said, we have the Portage County Color Guard is going to be out there. And then we're hopefully going to have a flyover when the national anthem goes over. And I'm talking.
I heard you got some connections.
Yeah,
there.
Mike Chimmel from Wausau Airport is going to do it. He's got a 1941 Stearman. The people that did it last year was Merrill and LaDonna McMahon. They might be coming along. And I talked to Guy Stewart at the Stevens Point Airport, and hopefully they got a couple of pilots, and maybe we can have a little string of them come past.
Great,
to honor
great.
The vets.
I think a lot of the people listening are already familiar with the Never Forgotten Honor Flights,
mm-hmm.
Where all across the country, people are allowing veterans to go to Washington, D.C. and visit their memorial. You hear a lot about that on the news, so I think that one's pretty well covered. But let's talk about the USSA flight or turkey hunts and the Ageless Aviation Dream Flights. Let's talk about that a bit.
The USSA is based out of Neillsville, and a woman there started it and wanted to give disabled kids and veterans turkey hunts, deer hunts, bear hunts, and stuff like that. So myself and Sheriff Lucas actually do that. He does it at Almond Rod and Gun Club. I do it up at Junction City. Mm-hmm. And the people of Portage County are gracious enough to open up their land to allow us to go turkey hunting there. And this year, we actually have a action track chair that Mr. and Mrs. Berard bought for us, and Mr. and Mrs. Bukowski bought a trailer for us. So now we have an action track chair that the veterans can use to get out in the outdoors and utilize those for the outdoor activities. And like I said, we take people out on turkey hunts. It's a free event for these people. They just show up, we take them out, we house them, we feed them, and then take them out turkey hunting, deer hunting, bear hunting, and it's a great event. The Ageless Aviation Dream Flight, a gentleman comes out of Texas, actually flies into the Stevens Point Airport with a biplane also, and then he gives veterans flights out of the Stevens Point Airport for one day. That'll be happening, it's gonna be, I think, May next year. And so we're looking forward to that. And we actually want a plane here in Stevens Point at some point in time. So we're trying to raise funds for that. So we're going to give some monies to Dream Flight also.
We're looking at raising about $100,000 to have that plane stationed here.
Correct.
To serve that whole northern part of the country, the Midwest. Because, again, he flies from Texas. So he told me, I think he made 11 stops on the way up just
yes.
for fuel in that Stearman. Now, he has an open cockpit Stearman as well.
Yes.
And I know that the firefighters were out there this year. If any of the disabled vets or vets had an issue trying to get into the plane, there's plenty of help there available.
Correct, yeah. We actually picked them right up out of their wheelchairs with the Foley lifts and carried them right up onto the wing, put a set them into the cockpit, strapped them in, and it was amazing just to see the smiles on their faces. I mean, their eyes were just lit up, and it basically changes their lives. It really does.
It does. And there's a YouTube video floating around somewhere. They had a GoPro in the cockpit, so you could kind of watch as the veterans were going up too. And the smiles on the guys' faces was pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Let's go back to the USSA. My brother-in-law has participated. He's got some land out there. He's allowed people to hunt on his land. I just found out, I haven't had a chance to tell you yet, because I know you scouted some of my land last year. But one of the neighbors that I just talked to, we don't get out there much this time of year, but
sure.
he told me we have a pretty good-sized turkey flock out there. So,
okay, great.
I don't know if you guys do a fall hunt. But
No, we don't, but we'll make sure we look you up next spring. So.
All right.
You can tie one up for us.
So, again, Guns and Hoses, the firefighters taking on law enforcement.
Law enforcement, yeah. This year we've beat the police the last 2 years pretty handily. So they actually recruited the Sheriff's Department and the Plover PD to come in. So they're gunning
ringers.
For us.
Sure,
so,
sure. Yeah. Well, and I'll be out there with my wife again doing the umpiring. We take a few liberties with the rules, as the assistant chief said. The score was pretty spread out, so we made some questionable calls on strikes and things like that to try and give the police department a fighting chance. But this year, I think it's going to be a pretty even up game. So again, that's August
27th. Gates open at 9:00. Like I said, opening ceremonies start at 10:30, and the game will start shortly after that. So stop on out with your family and friends. It's a family oriented event. It's free of charge. Stop out, have a hamburger, a brat, a hot dog. The Marine Corps League is actually doing all the cooking for us. The Sisters of Skates are serving the food, and it's a great event. So,
and that's at Manchesky Field
Buchholz Park.
Is at the end of Buchholz Avenue, ironically. Plenty of parking. I know that there's some raffles that are going to be going on. You'll be able to actually meet and talk to some of the veterans. I know a friend of mine, Will Lehner, is there every year. He's a Pearl Harbor veteran. And give you a chance to come out and meet some of our firefighters and some of our law enforcement. Cheer on your favorite team. Feel free to dress up in support of your favorite team and come out for a good cause for Guns and Hoses. Until next time, I'm Mayor Mike, along with Assistant Fire Chief Jeff Davis, and we thank you for Talking Point.